Good morning, students. So, in continuation to the last few lectures, here in this lecture, we'll study different aspects of yarn twist. All the formulas and all the related questions related to yarn twist, helix angle, TPI, TN. Different terms related to twist. We'll discuss all these here. So I'll start with the relation between surface helix angle, yarn diameter, and turns per unit length, that is TPI or TPM. We have discussed in idealized helical yarn geometry and also shown here in this diagram that tan alpha, that is where alpha is the surface helix angle, we can correlate surface helix angle with yarn radius, and H is the length of one turn, length of yarn of one turn of twist, which is inverse of TPC or TPI. So the next relation is between yarn radius, specific volume of yarn, and yarn linear density. We have already discussed this in last lecture. One more relation, that is text twist factor, is defined as turns per centimeter into square root of text. And if we find the conversion factor between text twist factor and twist multiplier of cotton count system, then we get this 9.57 number. I haven't shown the derivation here, and we are just trying to revise the formulas, related formulas, and then we'll solve the questions. Next is TPI, turns per inch, can be written as TM into under root cotton count system. One more fact about twisting is ki there are two types of unwinding yarn, overend unwinding and parallel unwinding. In case of overend unwinding, the twist in the yarn is changed. Basically, overend unwinding adds twist to the yarn. During unwinding, turns of twist are added to the yarn. Okay. Now, what are the norms for folding twist? That is, when we ply the yarn, or the twist given is according to the end use of the yarn. In case of knitting yarns, folding twist is half of the single yarn twist. And in general, for plied yarns, for balanced twist, we go for 2 by 3, that is 0.67. Different methods of twist measurement, we already know that contraction principle, twist and twist method for single yarns, and straightening method for plied and multifilament yarns we use. Here I would also like to remind you the two terms we have studied. One is contraction factor, which is always greater than one, and it is ratio of length of untwisted yarn to the length of twisted yarn. And retraction factor is change in the length upon original length, which is always less than one. We have studied the concept of geometrically similar yarns also. Now, what do we mean by geometrically similar yarns? The yarns having same cross-sectional area and same TPI, that is turns per unit length. Next, here we also revise two formulas related to strain in filament and strain in yarn with in relation to helix angle. So FCF is strain in filaments, FCY is strain in yarn, and theta is the helix angle. EY is elastic modulus of yarn, EF is elastic modulus of filament, and alpha is the surface helix angle. Now we'll discuss some numericals related to twist in the last few years of GATE question papers. Now first is of 2019. This question is, if the value of twist retraction of a yarn is 0.2, then we have to find the value of twist contraction. Now we have to remember here that retraction is change in length upon untwisted length, and contraction is untwisted length upon twisted length. So this is the relation between R and C, this formula, and we'll calculate the value of contraction, which is 1.25, and we also know that value of contraction factor is always greater than 1, and so the answer is 1.25. Now the second question is, the ratio of yarn tensile modulus to fiber tensile modulus where the surface fibers are inclined to a twist angle of 25 degree. So we have learned this formula that elastic modulus of yarn is equal to elastic modulus of fiber cos into cos square alpha. So if we have to find the ratio, that will be equal to cos square alpha, and alpha is given as 25 degrees. So the answer is 0.821. Now the next question is, in folded yarns, the folding twist is in opposite direction to the spinning twist, and the ratio required for the yarn free from such snarling tendency, that means we want a balanced twist. So for this we generally use the norm of 2/3, that is 0.66. so the we'll go for option B. Next is the final yarn count required from a ring frame is 36 ne with 28 tpi and twist contraction is 3%. Now the concept of twist contraction is there, and feed roving is given as 2 ne. The if the feed roving is given as 2 ne, the mechanical draft required in the ring frame will be. Now yarn count after twist contraction is 36, so first we have to calculate the yarn count before twist contraction, and then we'll calculate the mechanical draft. Now contraction factor is contraction is given as 3%, so contraction factor will be 1.03, and we'll calculate the yarn count. 36 into 1.03 will give you 37.08. so we require the mechanical draft of 18.5 here. Now in the next question, we are given that the denier of a multifilament yarn consisting of 300 filaments of 3 denier each becomes 1100 if 11 kilometer of untwisted filament yarn is twisted, its length in kilometer is. So basically we have to find the length of twisted yarn, which will be obviously less than 11 kilometer. So contraction is equal to twisted yarn length upon twisted untwisted yarn length upon twisted yarn length. If we convert it into denier, it will get reversed, that twisted yarn denier upon untwisted yarn denier. So 1100, we have that. Okay, so L we can calculate 11 into 900 upon 1100, which is 9 kilometers. Now we'll move to next question, in which twist contraction factor is given as 1.06, and we have to produce 5 ton twisted yarn of 50 ticks. So untwisted yarn length we have to calculate. Okay, now 5 ton is 5000 kg of twisted yarn of 50 ticks. So that will be 10 to power 5 kilometers, and contraction factor is 1.06. So the length of the untwisted yarn will be 1.06 into 10 to power 5. Okay. Now the next numerical is, the direct twist factor of 35 metric yarn, metric count yarn, is 36 TPC root tex. So we have to calculate TPI. Now first we'll calculate this TM from 36 and the divided by 9.57, as we know the relation between these two, and after that we'll go for first, then we'll convert 35 nm into ne and we'll calculate TPI, which is 17.09. Next question is, if the diameter of the above yarn is given as 0.28, we have to calculate the helix angle. Now tan alpha is equal to 2 pi rt, we know that, and we know the radius as 0.28 divided by 2, and TPC is, we have calculated in the last calculation, last question, that is 17.09 was TPI, and we'll convert it into TPC, which is 6.73, and apply this formula, and we'll get the value of alpha to be 30 degree. Now the next question is, 20s, 30s, 40s, 50s any cotton yarn have the same TPC, and we have to find the yarn having maximum fiber obliquity. Maximum fiber obliquity means which yarn has the highest TM. Now TM is inversely proportional to root NE. So when NE increases, TM decreases. So NE increases, TM decreases. So highest obliquity is there for 20s NE yarn. Now this is also similar question, but linear density is given in units of tex. So the highest twist factor will be for 60 tex. So we'll go for option D for descending order of helix angle of surface fibers. The next question, we are given that direct twist factor of 29.5 tex PV yarn is given as 38.28, and we have to keep twist per unit length the same of 30 any cotton yarn. So first we'll calculate the TPI, which should be same, and then we'll calculate TM from TPI under root any. So the answer is 3.27 calculated here. Now then, in the next question, this is a question of geometrically similar yarn, and it is given that 100% cotton yarn of 15 tex is to be replaced by cotton acrylic 70-30 blended yarn, and the diameter of the same twist and same diameter, geometrically similar yarn. So we have to calculate the linear density of the blended yarn. So first we have to calculate the density of the blended yarn by using this formula, that 70% cotton is there and 30% acrylic is there, and we need to know the both the fiber densities, and we'll calculate the fiber density of this blended yarn, which is 1.396 gram per cc. And after that, as we know that yarn tex is directly proportional to density, so we'll calculate the tex according to proportionality, and answer is 13.77 tex. Next question, we are given surface helix angle of point at in a yarn of 3.3 mm diameter is 30 degree, and we need to find the helix angle at a point 0.1 mm from the yarn axis. So 0.3 mm diameter means 0.15 from the yarn axis, and we have to find at a distance of 0.1 from the yarn axis. So we'll use this simple proportionality. Tan alpha is equal to, is directly proportional to 2r. So here I have taken 0.1 mm as the diameter, and by proportionality I have calculated 0.1924. In the next question, the contraction of the yarn upon twisting is given as 1.07, and twisted yarn count is 30 tex, and fiber linear density is given 2 decitex, and we have to calculate the number of fibers in the yarn cross section. So the most important part is, first we have to calculate the yarn linear density of the untwisted yarn, which is 30 upon 1.07, which is 28.04 tex. Then we'll calculate the number of fibers by dividing yarn linear density with fiber linear density, which is approximately 140.